بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد، in regard to this topic, goals of fasting. Fasting is one of the pillars of Islam. And pillars of Islam are assigned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our souls. As he subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Dariyat, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ الرِّزْقِ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. I created not jinn and mankind but to worship me. I need no assistance from them. Indeed, I am the sustainer. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us that all these obligations he made only for us to humble ourselves and purify our souls. Fasting is one of these worships, and that's why, since it was a method of purification of the soul, it was made obligatory upon all the nations, as Allah Ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. All you who believe, fasting is made obligatory upon you as it was made obligatory upon all those who were before you, for that you might have the taqwa, piety. So from there we know that Allah Ta'ala, certain ibadat, he made it for all the nations. Salah, Siyam, and Zakah. The Hajj, he did not make it obligatory upon all nations. It's only from Ibrahim and down. But from Ibrahim up, there was no Kaaba, there was no, you know. But they all were commanded to pray, fast, and give zakah. Because this purifies your soul. Although Hajj does, but this is, yani, Hajj requires you to be in a certain place, in certain time, so that you do this ritual. However, fasting, you can do it anywhere. That's why all the nations were told to fast. And Allah Ta'ala told us the purpose from legislating fasting. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So that the taqwa so that you might find the taqwa and have the taqwa be upon piety. And piety, as you know, that yani, it relates to the heart. The heart. And the heart is the store of faith. And faith is the motivator of all the body limbs to do the obligations. Without faith, and that's why Rasulullah said, التقوى ها هنا. Taqwa is here. And he pointed to his chest, meaning the heart. And he said, إِنَّ بِالْجَسَدِ مُضْغَى إِذَا صَلَحَ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدِ كُلُّ. In the body there is a muscle or a flesh. If it become good, all the body become good. All the body. And then he said it is the heart. So, the reason why fasting or the goal of fasting is to increase your iman. And that is why Allah Ta'ala, although he made fasting obligatory upon all nations, but he gave the Ummah of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam as an honor for his Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the month of Ramadan to be the month of fasting. Fasting used to be known to all nations, but not in Ramadan. And Allah Ta'ala, to honor this ummah, he descended the Quran as one complete unit in Ramadan, in a particular night in Ramadan, to the first day of Ibadah. And after that, it used to be descended based on the occasions and incidents. Allah Ta'ala told us why he descended the Quran in Ramadan, and then why he made fasting obligatory in Ramadan. He said, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل به القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. So Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was descended as a guide to the people, as a guide to the people, and clear proofs and evidences from the Quran that the dispute between the truth and false. Now this has a relation to the month in which fasting was made obligatory, and that's why Allah Ta'ala said after it, He began saying, "Oh, you who believe, fasting is made obligatory upon you, as it was made upon those who before you, so that you might have my bite." And then here Allah Ta'ala mentioned the month in which Quran was descended, and after that He said, "فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمْ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَصُمْ." So whoever, now the goal of fasting is great, but the goal of fasting Ramadan is greater, is the greatest, because Ramadan is the month in which Quran was descended, is the month in which there is a night, the reward of it equals reward or more than reward of 1,000 months, khayru min alf shahr, and Ramadan is the month in which Allah Ta'ala chained all the shayateen. So they don't have the ability to deceive people the way they used to before Ramadan. Allah Ta'ala made the whole, prepared the whole climate for you so that you increase your iman and taqwa. Iman and taqwa. And that's why the Prophet, and that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Hadith Qudsi, كُلُّ عَمَلِ ابْنِ آدَمْ لَهُ إِلَّا الصَّوْمُ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ يَدَعُ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ وَشَوَاتَهُ مِنْ أَجْلِ. All the worshipping deeds of son of Adam is for him, meaning already the reward of it decided. Except for fasting, it is for me. Not for me doesn't mean he does it sincerely for me. Otherwise, if he does salah insincerely, all the deeds, including siyam, is not accepted. وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ وَجَعَلْ وَلَوْ أَشْرَكُوا لَحَبِطَ عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. If they would have associated, all what they used to do would be made as a flying dust, as Allah Ta'ala said, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ وَجَعَلْنَا هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. Why? Because shirk was found in one of the ibadat that this person had. All the rest of the ibadat are not going to be accepted. Now, but when Allah Ta'ala said, إِلَّا الصَّوْمُ فَإِنَّهُ لِي, it means that the reward of it, I did not leave it for any angels or anybody. I am the one who's going to reward them. It's unlimited. It's for Allah the Almighty. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who's giving you, that means it's huge. It's huge. As what he said about patience, sabr. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. With no any limits or accountability, patience is going to be, the reward of patience is going to be given. Same thing with fasting. And when you fast, you can recognize that, you see it. When you fast, especially in Ramadan. Now you may fast outside of Ramadan, but you still see the difference. You still see the difference when you are in Ramadan outside of Ramadan. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ said, "من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة أن يدع طعام وشراب." So it means the goal of the fasting is to humble yourself, purify your heart, correct your deeds. He said, "He whoever does not stop the false actions and sayings, then Allah is not in need for him to leave his food and drink." Allah is not in need for us anyway. Allah is not in need for us. But that means your fasting is not going to be accepted. Or it's not going to be worthy to give you the goal that Allah Ta'ala made Siyam obligatory for. So the fasting increases your iman in your heart, purifies the heart with the taqwa. Purifies that. And that's why the Sahaba understood this. And so we hear Jabir radiallahu anhu, Jabir ibn Abdullah saying, إذا صمت فليصم سمحك وبصرك ولسانك عن الكذب والمحارم. When you fast, let your hearing, your sighting, your tongue fast from lying and from the honor of others. Meaning backbiting, slandering. And then he said, ولا يكن يوم صومك ويوم فطرك سواء. Don't let the day in which you are fasting be the same, meaning you be in it, the same as in the day in which you are not fasting. Meaning, you need to be humble in that day. And that's why he said, وَلْيُرَى عَلَيْكَ السَّكِينَةُ وَالْوَقَارُ. Let the tranquility and humbleness and piety seen on you. Not showing off, but when you realize that fasting is a great worship to Allah, and you do as you are told in the Quran, in the Hadith, about how to be in fasting, and in regard to, and as the other of Jabir, if you act upon that, necessarily humbleness, tranquility is seen on you. Necessarily. But if you don't care about these guidances and instructions, then you will see that, you will find that your fasting is not affecting, it's not improving you. It's not improving you. So the goal of fasting is to purify your soul, humble your heart, and increase the faith and piety. That cannot be if you make, if you treat the day of fasting of yours exactly the same as you treat the day which is in which you are not fasting. And that's why, Ikhwan, one day Prophet ﷺ is teaching us practically. One morning he said to the Sahaba, who of you become this morning fasting? Abu Bakr said, I also. It's not only Abu Bakr, by the way. It's not only Abu Bakr was fasting that day. Definitely, there were some others. But look at this. Prophet ﷺ asked, who of you today gave sadaqah? Abu Bakr said, I have seen. Believe me, it wasn't only Abu Bakr who gave sadaqah. But now Abu Bakr had two. Maybe someone else fasted. But other person gave sadaqah. Now Abu Bakr had the two. And he asked, who of you visited a sick person? Abu Bakr said, I have seen. Three. Then, who followed the janazah? Who prayed the janazah and followed it until his body? Abu Bakr said, I. Is it possible that the janazah only Abu Bakr in it? No. There are people who prayed or carrying it, but it means these deeds or duties were done by different people. Only Abu Bakr who had done them all in one time. Only Abu Bakr at that time who had done them all. And that's why, you see Abu Bakr, how humble he is, how pious he is, because he tries, in the day of fasting, he tries to do all good things. It's now your opportunity. Allah changed the shaitan for you. Your veins are narrow so the shaitan doesn't go through. Your stomach is empty, you are weak, so now you need to support that by other deeds. Other deeds to increase the iman. Why? When you are fasting, the iman is going high. And imagine now, you go and give sadaqah, the iman increases. You go and visit a sick, iman increases more. Pray janazah, you will come out of that day with full heart of iman. And maybe exceeds out. So that's why fasting has a a great goal, but for whom? Who understand? Who really use the day of fasting? Not like, and some of the setup, when they knew the goals of fasting, they worked for getting it on the best amount. Some of them closed their shots from beginning of Ramadan to the end. It's the only income for them. They say, no, we save our fasting. We save our fasting. Because business, you know, it has يعني some sort of, you know, things that may يعني take away of your iman or khushu'. Some others not only close their shops in Ramadan, they close their shops from Sha'ban, beginning of Sha'ban, and they came still in the masjid. They say, this is the month of Quran, getting ready for the month of Ramadan. So somebody who's staying in the masjid, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did i'tikaf the first 10 nights and then the second 10 nights and then the third, the last 10 nights. And in 1 year he missed the i'tikaf because he was in a journey of you know, jihad. When he returned in Shawwal, he did the i'tikaf. In Shawwal he did the i'tikaf. But the meaning of that is that when you are fasting, try to get the best advantage of that day. The best advantage. Because the heart is open now for Iman. You need to fill it with Iman. You need to fill it with Iman. You got the bucket of fasting, you poured it. You still have many other buckets to pour. Bucket of sadaqah, bucket of visiting grave, bucket of teaching people the knowledge. Pocket of enjoying the good and forbidding the evil. Pocket of helping needy. Someone want to carry something but it's heavy for him. You help him while you are fasting. This is great reward. It's great reward. So, yani, as a conclusion, the goals of fasting are huge, and they are to be felt more than to be said. And I'm sure that every one of you, alhamdulillah, I'm sure every one of you realize now the goals of fasting more than what I said. That's why, yani, Quran was yani sent down in Ramadan so that you read Quran, and that's why Jibreel used to come to Prophet Muhammad said to him, they did not used to review because they are afraid to forget it. No. They used to sit, read. Everyone read because they need to read it. They need to read it. Why? When you read the Quran, it increases your iman. As we said, and imagine, Jibreel used to sit to Prophet Muhammad, not in daytime, in night time when fasting is gone. So, he does, yani, he came to make a use of the night, recite the Quran with him. But Ibn Abbas linked that to the day. He said Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to be the most generous, and he was generous the most when in Ramadan, when Jibreel came and said to him and read within the Quran. Why? Because now fasting and holding himself from talking to yani whatsoever, although Rasulullah said never spoke yani lahu or, but he held himself from any of these things, no. If in case it's possible to happen. But above that, Jibreel used to come and sit with him and recite the Quran. So, if you want to get the best advantage and the biggest share of the goals of fasting, get use of your day. Get use of your day. By these guidances that the Prophet ﷺ taught us, Wallahu A'lam, wa sallallahu sallam, mubarak, al-Muhammad, we need to give some time for people to keep dua and, you know, And if you want to ask any question. No. Yeah, did I say that? Yeah, Sadaqah is feeding the poor.
You know, you must feed the something or you have to feed the poor.
What do you mean by must?
So that means that if that person has to feed the poor person, but sometimes they may not find it, they may not be solid.
The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, he whoever ask Allah sincerely and honestly the shahada, Allah will put him in the ranks of the shahada even if he dies on his bed. So if you are sincere in this and you did your best to find a court to give him, but you didn't find and you gave it to the masjid so that they give it on your behalf, then inshallah you are one of those. But laziness, I don't want to go find a needy or no one. I give it only to the masjid. No, that's, you will get the reward of sadaqah, but you're not going to be from those. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he used to go on. One day, Umar bin Khattab here knew that there was a woman who was poor and old in Medina. And she is lonely, doesn't have anybody. So Umar decided to go and serve her after Salat al-Fajr. When he came, he found the house kept tidy, clean. The goats, the sheep were milked. He asked, who did this? He said, Abu Bakr. He kept trying to come earlier, but things done. When the Prophet ﷺ passed away, and Abu Bakr took the khilafah, Umar said, now I can go before him and win, because he's now busy. He went and he found the same. He asked, who did this? She said, Abu Bakr. Said, wallahi, I don't compete with him. If you are sincere, you go to him. Abu Bakr could have just give the Prophet, and the Prophet give it to him. And the people come to the Prophet, the poor people come to him. But he went to the poor. Yes, if you are not able, then okay, you give it to the masjid and the masjid help you. But it's not correct that we all leave our responsibility and just give it to the masjid. That's, we can ask the masjid, show us where the poor, so we go and give them a response to them. But not all the time we rely on the masjid and we don't do anything. That's not correct. By the way, one day in Ramadan, in my masjid in Jeddah, at the end of Ramadan, we try to help the people in distributing the Zakat al-Fitr. So, 27, we start collecting. 28, we start giving out the Zakat. We have a big truck. Me and another brother, we drive that truck and go from Salat al-Dhuhr, 28, until morning 29. And sometimes we still have, so we stay until 9 of 8. But one day, in one year, when we were loading the truck with the zakah, with the rice, I hear someone saying, we don't know these people, where they take this rice to. Maybe they sell it. I was really upset. So I came to the mic and I said, Ya Ikhwan, we are only two and we are the imams, me and my assistant. We're the one who leads. We go and let the muaddin lead. Even the tarawih that night, the tahajjud, we are not there. We don't break our fast with our families, we don't do our duties, but only to serve them, because they say they don't know where the poor people are. So I said, but wallahi, we need help. And I kept saying that, we need help. Now, this is not only help, we need witnesses. A man, Jazallah Khair, came, he is somebody who's rich businessman, he said, I want to come with you, but don't misunderstand. I want to come and see the poor people. He's rich. I said, Jazakallah khair, come. He went with us, he cried. He couldn't believe. When we took him to where the poor people, they are, and Africans living there in Jeddah, their situation is worse than the Africans in Africa, I saw them. Wallahi. So sometimes, and this place where the poor people are not far from my masjid. Maybe 20 minutes driving. But they don't want to go. People become so lazy. They don't know that their steps, when they take their sadaqah and go to the poor, their steps are written for them. And now the poor people know me and my friend, that's it. But if they see the people come, they would love them. They would love the Muslims. Because all the Muslims are coming, and, you know. So my advice is, try to, I understand the situation here. You are in a kuffar country. People are, alhamdulillah, most of them are okay, they are not poor. And you cannot recognize the poor from their houses, not like in back home or in your countries. You can't recognize who is poor from their houses, from the way they dress. Here you cannot. Here you cannot. But at least, I say, if you can't take it to the poor, come give a hand to the masjid. Say, we want to help in this poor aid. Maybe they need you. Definitely they will need you. You know? By that, I hope that you get the reward that the Prophet ﷺ mentioned. Allah.
طيب
ان شاء الله سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت